I have a bucket full of chemicals and a handful of surprising results. Let's talk about some resin cleaning alternatives. Just before you skip ahead to find out the TLDR, it's propylene glycol, and I'd really appreciate a thumbs up. What's up? I'm Jonathan, and welcome to Maker Tales. This video is sponsored by Thangs. As you can tell, we're looking at alternatives for cleaning resin prints. More specifically, I'm looking for safe and non-flammable alternatives, so I'm not really looking at price here, I'm looking mainly at safety. So with that said, the first thing you're probably going to think is, hey, just go simple green, just go mean green. I can't do that. I'm based in the UK, and in fact, all of the EU, we just don't have mean green or simple green. And if we do want to get that, we need to import it in at these crazy prices, and that's just not going to happen. Now, for me personally, I'm finding an alternative because I almost blew myself up the first time that I was looking into resin printing, because I have a teeny tiny workshop. I was doing a lot of spraying of IPA to clean my prints, and the vapor buildup got really high. And then when I took my mask off, I realized one spark and that would have gone boom. Now, yes, I can ventilate more. I could open up my door, but keep in mind that this is my workshop that I keep at a constant 25 degrees and up. I also keep it at a constant of 40% humidity because I'm doing SLA and I'm doing FDM in there, and I'm based in Scotland. So if I open up that door, I'm literally fighting against Mother Nature to keep that constant. And I'm just not about that. So I had to find a safer alternative. And that's what leads me to this video right here. Now, as I can't get simple green or mean green, I basically just bought every industrial degreaser that I could get my hands on, which were all of these here. And then I also looked at all the material data safety sheets in all of them, saw if there were any good chemicals that kept popping up, and also did a whole bunch of research online and finding forums and stuff. And there were two main ones that kept coming up, which was sodium carbonate, which is basically soap, and also propylene glycol, which is crazy because that's a food preservative mainly, as well as a cosmetic agent, which is a little bit weird, and it's food safe. I don't know. It just was weird. So let me talk about the methodology. Now, when it comes to the methodology, I wanted to try and stay as fair and consistent as possible. So I stuck with the Amira Labs little test, torture test city thing here, and I did all 12 at the same time. Yes, 12. Even though you might see that I only have 9 different chemicals, there's 12 in total because we have no cleaning at all. We have IPA 99.9%, and we also have water. So I just wanted to really show what we get. And also, here's a great example to show you why we do the cleaning in the first place. Now you might be thinking, hey, that one that hasn't had any cleaning at all is very resin logged. Why does it look that bad? Well, it's actually to do with consistency. What I basically did was take them all off the build plate and then put them into a bag of resin, because I was going to do this sort of methodology of cleaning. Take it out from that bag, put it into another bag just with the chemical, give it a little slosh about in my hands, then put it down into my ultrasonic cleaner for exactly 5 minutes. Take it out from there, pull it out, dunk it in some nice fresh water. Then I use some hair dryer on it, a little bit of air compressor, and then hair dryer once again, and then I put that to cure for 3 minutes. And I did that for absolutely every single one. I kept it as consistent as possible. There was no brushing, no nothing. It was basically as much out of my hands as it could be, so I could be as consistent within all of this, so that it really was the actual chemical working on it and not my sort of labor at it. Because in reality, you can pretty much clean anything with anything if you just feel like really putting in the time and cleaning it with a brush and so on and so forth. This is why you can really dilute IPA all the way down and still it's quite cleanable with it, because it still dissolves it a little bit. Now, talking about the whole dilution, I felt like keeping this as consistent as possible and using no dilution whatsoever for all of these. So these are all as pure as possible. The only one, which is the sodium carbonate, that is basically 4 parts water, 1 part sodium carbonate, because that is pretty much as much as I found that I could dissolve into the water itself. So it's as sodium carbonated as possible. Now let's talk about results. But just before that, let's have a quick interesting word from this video sponsor, Thangs. As you may know, Thangs is a community for all kinds of 3D enthusiasts with a selection of over 3.5 million free models to download. They support 27 different file types and are planning to add even more. They are constantly updating and improving and currently have a very interesting alpha workspace which you can apply to test out. It's basically GitHub for 3D models. In other words, 3D version control, which just blows my mind. So be sure to check Thangs out using the link down in the description. Using that link, you're not only just checking out a great community, but you're also helping me out to create more videos like these. And for that, thank you. Now jumping straight into the results, I'm going to break this into two batches of six, the lower six and then the top six. Remember that obviously the worst spot is going to be not cleaning at all and the best spot is IPA, but we're trying to see and measure between those two spots in itself. So the bottom six was obviously nothing at all. Then we had sodium carbonate. That's right, we had something that was worse than water, which is the next one. Then we had autogleam, citricline, and gunk ultra. I wouldn't suggest any of these at all because quite frankly, they sucked. Just don't use them, they just don't work. Then from there we have the top six, and that's where things get interesting. Starting off, we have Super TFR, then we had two that were pretty much identical, which is Muck Off and Gunk Green, and then we had No Nonsense and Propylene Glycol, and number one was IPA. So the best one out of all of these was Propylene Glycol. This was a real surprise to me because I did all of these tests completely blind. I had no idea what was what. There was just a little number on the bottom of all of those, went to another room, and then I graded them. And when I found out that it was propylene glycol, it was mind-blowing. Now, propylene glycol is a really interesting result because you can get it in small batches, big batches, and huge batches because it's an ingredient used in many different industries, from the cosmetic industry to medical industry, to the e-cigarette industry and smoke machine industry. That's right, propylene glycol is the active ingredient that makes smoke machines smoke smoke. And in fact, the more propylene glycol is in that liquid, the longer and thicker that smoke will be. So who would have thought? Smoke machine liquid, huh? Now, there's a lot more interesting things about this. For instance, this one specifically is vegan. It's also food safe, so technically you could eat this, but I wouldn't suggest it because it's just a preservative. In the medical industry, it's used to remove excess water. In the cosmetic industry, it's a preservative as well as a medium. So it's pretty safe stuff. Now, of course, once you use it with resin, it's no longer safe at all. And there's a lot more testing for me to do here. For instance, it's thicker than water, so I can't spray this through a bottle. So I'm going to have to see if I can dilute this in some way and see if it still works. I don't know if it becomes resin logged really quickly. I also don't know if it separates maybe the resin, because this is thicker than water, it might separate. It might also basically be unusable after three prints. So I don't know. There's a lot of testing to go, but it's definitely interesting. Now, something I said I wasn't going to do that I am going to do is talk about price. It is more expensive than IPA. Just for an example, I get my IPA at about £17.50. That includes tax and postage. And the cheapest that I can get the propylene glycol is from a wholesaler for about £18.50 plus tax plus shipping. So as you can see, it's a little bit of a gray area there, because in reality, I'm probably going to be paying £30 for 5 liters. But for me, that's worth it just due to the safety. And that was the key thing that I was looking for here. Anyway, that there are my results. A huge thank you to my patrons. You guys are absolutely awesome, and it means the world to me to have your support. It's what makes Maker Tales possible, basically. And if you're enjoying what I'm making here, you think I'm worthy of your support, I would love to see you there too. Don't forget that we have a Discord, and that's linked down in the description. Thank you for watching, keep making, and let the quest continue.